drama.
It's come out to Bucknell for three. God, what a shot by Steve Bucknell.
Let's get it on. It's the London Derby as the top two teams in the South, the Towers and the Leopards, tango. We're at the Crystal Palace, but it doesn't matter where the game is played when these two teams meet. I'm Kevin Cato, and welcome to the 35th meeting between these two organizations. The Towers, who have won 21 of those derby games, are also top of the Southern Conference and have qualified for the playoffs, as has the Leopards, with the Lions and Bullets looking good possibilities. The Sheffield Sharks and Chester Jets are playoff bound from the North, with the Eagles, Riders trying to cement their positions. Today, it pleases me to welcome Nigel Lloyd, coach of the Milton Keynes Lions. Nice, thanks for joining us. The Towers have a 19-game winning streak in the championship. The Leopards have won their last six. Whose streak will be broken today?
I think the Leopards' streak will be broken today just for the fact the Towers are playing at home. And because of the big game this is and all the travel they've been doing, they want to give their home court fans something to be proud of.
Okay, we'll look out for that, Nigel. Now, Suzanne Dando is away ill today, and we wish her better. Rob Dugdale controls the sidelines, and it's over to him.
Thanks very much, Kev. I think Suzanne's missed out on a real humdinger tonight, because the rivalry between these two teams, I think, is as close now as it's been over the last few seasons. Already this season, we've had one overtime game and also two 2-point games, and I think we're going to have another one which is going to be very close tonight, so look out for that. I'll be here at halftime to bring you the latest news from around the league, and also I'll be bringing the interviews between the two protagonists of this game later on. For the moment, though, back to you, Kev.
All right, Rob, thanks for that. Did you know that 35% of these London derbies have been decided by just a basket? So, hold on to your seat. Nigel joins the maestro, Daniel Routledge, for the start of the game.
Thanks a lot, Kevin. Let's get straight into the team rosters for today's games. And Towers, in all competitions, are on their best winning streak of the season. Having won their last 12 contests home and abroad, they're in the playoffs both in the NEBL and over here. In the starters, former Leopard Eric Burks gets the nod in the backcourt alongside Randy Duck. Watch, though, for Bucknell and Henlon. Nobody knows these derby games better than they. To the visitors, and despite suffering injuries of late, the Leopards have confirmed their playoff berth this week, and their six-game winning streak has seen them take a firm grip on second place in the South. With Rod Brown struggling with a knee injury, Gareth Davids gets a start. It changes the complex of their lineup, just the two guards with three up front. The two sides are out and ready to go. It looks like Rico Alderson will jump it up. Nobody gone yet from the Towers. Now it's Kendrick Warren who beats Martin Henlon there. Warren wins the tip. Burks back to Duck. And Randy Duck will bring the London Towers forward. Bucknell has it. To Henlon. Back to Steve Bucknell. Now trying to get it into Kendrick Warren. Great pass, and Martin Henlon lays in. And the Towers have the opening score of the game. Now, Nigel, the bookmakers say Towers by 5 points, which seems a high margin for 1 and 2 in the conference.
I think so, but I think maybe they're taking into consideration the injuries that Leopards had earlier, the last couple of games.
Mo Robinson gets the first score of the game for the Leopards, ties the game up at 2. So Towers have certainly started better than they did the last time we saw these two teams. Towers had one lead in the game, and that was on the last shot. Here's Bucknell, who hit that shot, going for three, a little bit short, but there's Kendrick Warren on the offensive glass. The finger roll doesn't go, and here come the Leopards. They've got to keep Warren and Henlon off the glass, though.
Oh, most definitely. It looks like Leopards have started a bigger lineup as well with Davidson.
Robinson gets it to Alderson. Great block out by Henlon. The Leopards will keep possession, but no reset on the clock. He didn't get the shot off, 13 to go. Out to Davis. Time running out on the offense. Fed to Robinson, back out four on the shot clock as he gets it off Rashard Johnson. Good little combination between him and Robinson.
Oh, that was excellent basketball by Leopards. What you see is good unselfish play from Maurice Robinson to find open Rashard Johnson.
Randy Duck losing the ball out of bounds there, so the Leopards will get it back. Alderson keen to get it in quickly, but the rest of his team weren't quite as speedy as he. Here he is back on the ball to Robinson now.
Looks like Leopards are running a little triangle, and they're playing a two-man game with Rashard.
One-handed, Warren pulls it out of the air. Duck has it up top.
Looks like the triangle is being run on the other side by Towers.
Eric Burns forced to back out, trying to get it into Bucknell. Tough pass, no reset on the clock. Duck has to shoot it up, does, off the back of the ring. And a rebound for Jason Kimbrough. The quick pass to Alderson is broken up by Randy Duck. And the Leopards will keep possession of the boards.
Looks like Leopards are going to try to run the ball up the court on Towers anytime they get a chance.
Good pass inside. Burke's got a block on that one. Davis trying to get a tip. Second attempt doesn't go. He'll have three goes at it. Duck blocks him from behind. And Eric Burks comes up with it.
It looks like the referees are going to let this game play right now. This is only for the big boys inside.
Randy Duck just crossing the line in time. 8 seconds allowed to do so. He only just did it. Burks off the glass. Eric Burks against his old team gets his first score of the night.
Yeah, Eric Burks is playing some good basketball for London Towers right now. Coming off of 26 points against Edinburgh.
One-handed high off the glass from Mo Robinson.
Good shot by Mo. Good power move. Good jump hook. He's going to try to make Martin play some defense.
First time this year Martin's got a start against the Leopards. He is the most experienced in these rivalries on the either side. Warren inside is blocked by Davis, comes out to Bucknell. Bucknell to the finger roll, didn't quite go. Might have came off Davis' leg last, yes it did. So Towers will keep it back. Good work from Henlon on the board.
Very good work. Also, I like the athleticism of Davis. He's really hustling, he's playing hard. A lot of people wouldn't have seen him, but he's a good young English talent. He's finally getting a chance to show himself.
Inside to Kendrick Warren. Easy score for Warren as he came around the screen, left Alderson behind it.
That was a great pass by Steve Bucknell and a good finish by Kendrick Warren. It's Towers height right there.
Alderson with the jump shot doesn't go. Bucknell with the rebound at the back, and they do have a lot of big bodies, the London Towers, on that glass. Here's Duck going along the baseline. Nice move from Randy Duck. Towers back up by a couple.
Good aggressive move by Duck. I think Rico was trying to get Warren back. That's not the shot that Bob would prefer him to take. Now Bob comes in calling offense.
Kimbrough to Alderson up top, around to the far side, and Davis trying to get it. Good hands from Duck to break it up. It came back though to Rashard Johnson, who levels the game at 8.
Good hustle play by Rashard. This Leopards just quicker to the ball than Towers right now.
Both teams shooting 50%, 4 of 8. The scores are tied at 8. Bucknell spinning round. Davis will be called for it. Bob Dunnewald claiming the hook round on Steve Bucknell. Davis thought the same thing. Here's another look at it. Bucknell going round. Didn't see too much of a hook. Probably was the right call on that one.
I think what you have is Bucknell. Davis hasn't been playing a lot of minutes, so he's a little tired, so he didn't move his feet as well on that play. And Bucknell being a veteran, taking the ball aggressive to a young
small
guy.
Small play by Eric Burks. A little head fake, cut back door. And he was wide open and found by Steve Bucknell for an easy lay.
I spoke to Burks earlier before the game, and he just said it's just a comfort level they have right now, and the fact that he's playing a little more, that's why he's playing a lot better. Just a little time on the court to feel his flow with the players.
Alderson driving to the basket. Henlon denies him. Away come the Towers with Bucknell. Burks was the leading scorer midweek, 26 points against Edinburgh. Seems to be getting back to some of his form that he was at during the Leopards. The foul was called there on Kimbrough. Here's the defensive play by Henley, just straight up. Leopards running quickly. Johnson towed the line. Ball comes all the way back out to Kimbrough. He lets it go from deep and knocks it out.
That was a good play. Good hustle rebound by Kimbrough, and he got the shot he wanted. Also on the last fast break, the foul on Steve Bucknell was an excellent play by Kimbrough, using his brains, because Towers were coming down 3-on-2 and they possibly had an easy 2 points. Instead, they had to take it out to the side.
And eventually turned the ball over. Duck with a wide open jump shot. The bounce won't quite go. 4 Leopards going after it. They come up with it. Kendrick Warren stopping the fast break with a foul.
That's Leopards team defense against Tower size. You got four Leopards jumping against Martin Henlon. They know they have to rebound as a group.
There's the foul by Kendrick Warren, just blocking the fast break more than anything else. Midway through the first quarter, the Towers trailed the Leopards by a point. Before the game, we had a chat with Towers coach Nick Nurse and asked him about playing
Leopards
the Leopards.
Are another good measuring stick for us. You know, we figured out a way to win over a bunch of different games, over a bunch of different teams. Now let's see if we can figure out how to beat these Leopards and kind of make a statement doing it. And we said that going into Sheffield a couple weeks ago after they knocked us out of the trophy. We meant business and we wanted to kind of send them a message. Now I think we got to take that same attitude against the Leopards. I think they're a good basketball team. They play hard. They certainly compete with us. They've certainly given us problems. And we got to see if we can make that right and take it to them and be aggressive and fight through all the things that they do well and do our things well and come out on top.
Well, they've certainly showed their strength over the last few weeks. They, in the space of 8 days, they beat the top three in the Northern Conference by double figures. They'll be wanting, as Nick said, to send a message out here and beat the number two team in the South.
Oh, yes, I think Nick just wants to show that there's a gap in the South. There's them and then there's the rest of us. And I think that's the point they're trying to prove. The Leopards now, they're trying to show that they can compete with the top teams in the South, and Nick and them just got lucky earlier.
Good steal from Kendrick Warren. Is that a backcourt? Kimber might have just been in his own half when he picked it up. He's certainly close. The alley-oop was almost tipped in by Martin Henlon. Twice they've tried to do that. Neither time it paid off, and Burks runs it back, the leading scorer in the game with six. Eric Burks
is playing comfortable. He's running the floor well. I think all his injury worries must be gone by now.
Mo Robinson, a 20-foot jump shot is short. Rebound, Kendrick Warren.
I don't know if Bob would want Mo pulling up for jump shots like that most of the game. That would play more into Tower's hands.
Three on none. Alderson with the big slam on the break. Nobody getting back for the Towers.
No, you got Leopards athleticism right there. I think Randy took an ill-advised shot, though, and that's what caused Leopards to be running.
Henlon to Warren around the trail. Good hands knocked away by Rashad Johnson. Here he is with the ball. Goes around the screen, hands over to Robinson, who almost throws it away, but Johnson dancing through the basket. Beautiful move by Rashad Johnson.
Rashad Johnson is playing inspired basketball. I like the way he's attacking the basket. If the Leopards big men attack the basket the same way, then Leopards will really have a better chance.
3-point lead for the Leopards. It's the biggest in the game thus far for either team. A lot of alley-oops been thrown here in the early doors. None of them have got close to coming off.
Both of the teams are very athletic, I don't understand.
Alderson inside, sold the head fake, finished it off, thought he got fouled as well, and his coach jumped up straight away and said, calm down, Rico. Don't go after the referee like that.
That's a good, smart coaching by Bob.
Bucknell penetrating strong. Ball almost ends up in his hands. It was touched by Rico Alderson, who was stood out of bounds at the time. So the Towers will go back. Here's another look. If you have a look, there's Alderson stepped out of bounds when he touched the ball. Towers making it sub with Warren going to the bench. And here's Rod Brown checking into the game for the Leopards. He struggled with a knee injury. Didn't play last week against Thames Valley. Or midweek against Manchester, but they were always hopeful that he might be back for this game. We'll see how much he can get.
I spoke to Brown before the game. He said this is his first game. He's going to give it a shot and try it for the first time. He said he feels good, though.
Certainly makes a difference to the Leopards squad not having Rod Brown. They are famed for their three-guard backcourt. And take away one of the cogs, and it doesn't quite work as well. Good hands, although that said, Leopards are unbeaten in six, so there you go. Burks running back to another finger roll. Eric Burks, 4-4, leading scorer with 8 points.
Eric Burks is just playing good basketball. I mean, he's just using his size advantage on the Leopards' guards as far as laying it in.
Towers come up with another steal. Bucknell has it in the corner, looking for Henlon on the trail. Henlon now gets it, but was always struggling to hang on to that pass, and the Leopards will get it from the end line.
I think on that play, Nick Nurse was even pointing that Taylor was open, but Steve Buckner didn't see him. He thought he had a mismatch with Martin inside.
Johnson with the touch, and Rashad Johnson has eight early here.
This is a typical Capital clash right now. Both teams are playing their best basketball, and what a good time to do it.
I tell you, the only untypical thing about it is there's only been three fouls here in the first quarter. Alderson kicks it back out. Johnson fires for three, way too long. Is that a foul on Baker boxing out on Alderson? I think he was grabbing round Rico Alderson as he tried to box him out. So it was a foul on Ronnie Baker. Bottom left of the screen, there's Baker grabbing him from behind to stop him going after it. Good spot from the official.
Yeah, I think that was a good call by Fisher. Also, I think that was a smart foul by Ronnie, because if he doesn't do that, Rico grabs the rebound and lays it in. So that's just what we call just being smart. Now they have to take the ball out and then try to shoot a harder shot.
Although the way Johnson's shooting right now, there is no hard shot. 10 points, first man into double figures, Rashad Johnson.
Rashad Johnson came to play today. I don't want to say it's the shoes, but he and Bob and Ed, most of the team have the same new shoes on.
They do. Even the owner, Ed Simons, has the same shoes on. It's some sort of fashion statement in Brentwood, obviously.
Yes, I talked to him before the game, and Bob said he was using that to inspire the team.
Here's Rashad Johnson. Nice feed to Robinson, and Robinson lays it in off the assist from Rashad Johnson. Leopards have suddenly opened up a seven-point lead, the biggest of the game by some distance.
Leopards is playing well. What the thing is, can you do it for 40 minutes? When I spoke to Bob before the game, I said with Towers, you have to do it consistently for 40 minutes of the game. You can't lapse. If they can play this way for 40 minutes.
Bucknell driving to the basket, draws the foul from Rico Alderson. Alderson arguing the case here. Here's Buck going strong, and Alderson in front. Shot did not go for Steve Bucknell, so he'll shoot two.
On that play, you just saw veteran Steve Bucknell taking the ball aggressive. We've been saying that a lot of fouls have been called, so Bucknell has now decided that he's going to make the referee make a call.
Bucknell becomes the last of the starters for the Towers on the score sheet. Two and two for Steve Bucknell. He'll get himself a breather for these last 12 seconds of the first quarter as Wayne Henry checks in for him.
This normally, Leopard should take the last shot, but if they don't, they definitely have to watch out for Henry, because he can come off the bench and stick a three at any moment.
Kimbra is fouled with a couple of seconds left by Ronnie Baker. That'll be number two on Baker.
You have to like Kimbrough's aggressiveness. I think he's maybe found the one guy in the league that he can take the ball strong and aggressively to and shoot over, and Ronnie Baker. So I think he had to take advantage of his size for the first time.
Kimbrough now will have a chance to stretch the lead out to seven if he can make both. The rims out on the first. Kimbra makes the second, couple of seconds for Towers to maybe get one off. Henlon throws it the length. That'll end up in Henry's hands. Henry gets it off on the buzzer, but not quite. And the London Leopards, thanks to Rashad Johnson's double figures in the first quarter, finish strong. They lead the Towers by six. We'll be right back after this.
At Old Trafford, West Ham achieved the impossible. And at the Stadium of Light, they did it again.
We'll be going into the quarterfinal, that's a fact.
Now they face Spurs, who are hoping for cup magic in 2001.
Simon Davis!
Then in the Scottish Cup, Dundee United face the might of Rangers, desperate in their quest for silverware. A great cup double starting with the AXA-sponsored FA Cup tomorrow from 3, live on Sky Sports 2 and Extra.
Don't search, just yell.com.
Welcome back to Crystal Palace, where the Towers trailed the Leopards in the London Derby by 6, and the shooting stats bear that out. Leopards shooting 11 of 19 here in the first quarter.
Yeah, I think Leopards are taking the shots that their shots, really.
And level on the boards, but 6 turnovers by the Towers, who only averaged 10 a game, the best in the league all season. That's too many.
That's very much too many. That's what probably the league is going through right now.
And if we have a look at the leadometer, you can see there was absolutely nothing in it for the first 5 minutes or so. And just right there at the end, the Leopards pulled away with the basically coming off the steals and running it back. They've had 11 points off those 6 Towers turnovers.
But that's the key to the game right now. Towers can take care of the ball because they've been doing it well all year.
The Towers using the full 2 minutes. Kendrick Warren just having a chat with the referee as well as he comes out of that break. And we're ready to go. It'll be Rico Orderson to jump it up. I think Kendrick Warren will eventually get in there. Yes, he will. And Mo Robinson comes down with it, finds Johnson. Johnson drives to the basket. Great move, and Rashard Johnson is really feeling it here. 12 points, 6 of 7 shooting.
Yeah, he's just taking the ball aggressive, too. He's not just settling for the jump and hoping it goes in. He's taking the aggressive, taking high percentage shots for his team.
Duck out to Henlon and Taylor. Good ball movement.
Looks like Leopards are some kind of zone.
Warren for 3. That doesn't go. Henry a little bit too aggressive going after the rebound is called for the foul.
Yeah, it looked like Leopards were in some kind of zone because I saw Mo Robinson running all over the place. That's the hardest I've seen him work on defense in a long time. So you can see how Leopards are taking the game. Needs to also put on those shoes as well.
There's a look. There's Henry coming on the backside. They're just going over the top. It seems that everybody from the owner downwards all has the same shoes on the Leopards team. And Rashard Johnson fires up for 3, and you know you've taken it when you step up with shots like that.
Rashard Johnson is having an unbelievable game. Right now he's carrying them.
And the Leopards open up an 11-point lead. They seem to do this against the Towers early on. They seem to have the ability to just get way ahead as Kendrick Warren will go to the line for an and one as he took it to the basket.
I think what's happening also now, you see Towers, they're going to their main guy. I don't think Warren has been touching the ball an awful lot. He hasn't been involved. They haven't been going back to their height advantage. So now what's happening is Nick's probably told him, take it inside, get it to a height advantage, just beat him up on inside, then come out.
And Kendrick Warren has 5 personal points after that 3-point play. Bob Dunnewell getting ready to bring Michael Martin into the game.
If I'm Leopards, I'd be setting up something for Rashard.
Kimbra with the jump shot. Henlon fighting with Mo Robinson. Henlon must have touched it last, although he has a look of innocence as he went to run the other way down the court. Here's another look. And could have been either way, but the vet there was off and running, as you would well know, Nigel.
I would expect nothing less from Martin. I would have done the same thing, exactly. Try to influence the referees any way you can.
Nice spin from Rico Orderson. Had a bit too much on the layup. Saved by Eric Taylor. Here comes Randy Duck for the left Towers. To Henry. Plants his feet, but is a little bit short as Johnson gets the rebound. There's the rebounding in the game. Now, you would expect the Towers, with their extra height, would have had an advantage here, but not the case.
I think you have to look at Leopard's athleticism. They're really playing hard. If they can keep this up for 40 minutes, and that's what happens, Tower size normally wears teams down. But right now, if Leopard can keep up this athleticism, they're just out-hustling Towers and out-jumping Towers to the balls right now.
Foul there on Michael Martin as he went with Henlon for the rebound. Henlon wants it in the post. Kendrick Warren takes it at Rico Orderson, who hit the deck, and the charging foul is called on Kendrick Warren. Number 2 on the big man.
That was excellent defense by Rico. It's like he just read where Kendrick was going, and Kendrick lowered the shoulders. You can see on the replay. That was a very good call by the referee. That could also be a problem for Towers because they need Kendrick Martin in this game.
Yeah, with Perry Carter out injured still through his knee problem, he had a minor operation on it. They don't go quite as deep in the big man department as they used to.
And also, then they'll be playing right into Leopard's hands. Leopard plays a small game better than most teams in this league.
Robinson, dish off to Martin. Martin up in the air, nowhere to go, threw it away. Here comes Duck to Warren. Warren, oh, great head fake from Kendrick Warren. Sent Martin and Robinson flying and then slammed it home. Take a look at this head fake. They all went past him, and he finished it off.
That was a good move. That's why Towers needs Mark Kendrick in the game.
They're 4 points from four Leopards turnovers, but the thing that's really hurt them is the other way, with Leopards converting eight Towers turnovers for 11 points. The Towers coughed the ball up way less than anybody else in the league, only 10 per game.
I don't think the Towers fans agree with the foul because they think Rashad Johnson threw an elbow before the play. And that's what Randy Duck was complaining about.
Rashad Johnson arguing his case with the referee. He got the call on that occasion. So. Lobbed into Mo Robinson, fires over Henlon. Henry tips it up, so does Henlon, but it comes all the way to Johnson. Rashad Johnson doesn't go, but the rebound comes out long to Alderson. Robinson, Martin. Good quick movement from the Leopards. Michael Martin's shot doesn't go, and this time Wayne Henry gets two hands on it.
Bob has to be happy with the ball movement of his team.
Duck.
Nick cannot be happy with Duck right there on that
Yeah,
shot.
But at least he chased down his own rebound. It wasn't the greatest option, but he did get his own rebound. Burks for three, knocks it out. Eric Burks hasn't missed a shot in five attempts. He's got 11 off five of five shooting.
That's down to Randy Duck. Good hustle play, and then finally at the point guard, he found an open teammate with a good look.
Towers eight in a row have trimmed this back down to three here early in the second quarter. It was 11 just moments ago. Great block from Martin Henlon to throw out the shot from Rico Alderson. There's Henlon.
Good help defense by Henlon because he noticed that Rico had the mismatch down low on Steve Bucknell.
Shot clock holding at five as they inbound to Rashad Johnson. He's missed his last couple now. Good save from Henry. Away come the Towers with Eric Burks. Burks, oh, beautiful play. Goaltend by Rico Alderson. It was on its way down. A super move from Eric Burks.
That's what you call a vintage Eric Burks on the break. Just lulling the defender to sleep and then putting it up nice and soft. The only way you can stop it is by goaltending.
That was definitely on the way down. Good athleticism from Alderson, but it was a goaltend. 6 of 6 from Eric Burks for 13. He leads his team, and now it's down to just a point. Leopards haven't scored in over 3 minutes now. Here's Johnson. Oh, Bucknell with the block, but a goaltend on that one. Bucknell getting up high to throw that one out. That one was judged on its way down as well. Let's have another look. Yeah, it probably was. Yeah,
I haven't seen Steve Bucknell jump that high in years. And this game is bringing out a lot of surprises and a lot of players.
Duck off the big screen from Henlon out to Bucknell. Bucknell penetrating to the basket out to Wayne Henry for three. Yes, Wayne Henry strokes the three and ties the game at 31.
I was watching Wayne Henry in warm-ups today, and he shot maybe 10 out of 11 shots from that corner and all went in.
Number three in the league in three-point shooting, 46% plus for Wayne Henry this season. Kimbra off the glass, just a little bit too much on it, and Wayne Henry was called for a foul as he tried to prevent Dave Atwell going back up.
And you must notice that Towers is doing this with Kendrick Warren on the bench. So the bench players are really stepping up in this game and providing a spark.
Number two on Wayne Henry, Atwell at the line, makes the first. Dave Atwell makes some both. And the Leopards up three. Two. Burks. Eric Burt spinning into a double team, gets it round to Henry. Henry driving baseline and was triple teamed. One of them was whistled for a foul. Seven, says the referee, Gareth Davis, number two.
Good aggressive move by Wayne Henry. He's just not settling for the three-point shot. He's taking it strong to the basket, making them have to foul him.
Davis and Atwell going to the bench. This is the total fouls situation, 7-6. We are midway through the second quarter, 7-6, which is amazingly low when these two teams get together.
It's definitely low. Either they're playing high caliber basketball or the referee is just letting it play. But there's nothing in it. 7-6, you can't be upset if you're either one of them.
Oh, it was almost tipped in by Rico Orderson. Had it gone in, it would have been worth two, as he'd got a hand to it, but it didn't. So the Towers still trail by a point midway through the second quarter here in the London Derby. Kimber with the pull-up J, doesn't go. Martin's in there fighting for it. He touched it last, so the Towers will get it back.
That was a good hustle by Michael Martin. Towers are now trying to compete. Towers also have a small team and one big guy and four guards.
Duck for three. Yes, all string from Randy Duck. The Towers are in front for the first time since the opening exchanges. Martin at the elbow, short on his jumper. It comes out to Bucknell. Bucknell breaks his way through, and a foul was called on Michael Martin. That's the second on him.
That was a veteran play by Steve Buckman. He just baited Martin into fouling him. I think the ball must be wet.
Bob offering the towel up for it to be dried and using the opportunity to have a quick chat with the referee.
Which is smart coaching because it was other team's ball, so I can make them dry it themselves. But I'm not that good a coach yet.
You're not doing bad, third in the conference. Duck, oh, his shot just didn't bobble in. Johnson, oh, he lost it off his own leg. Bucknell came up with it. He's got all teammates ahead. Now he goes past all on his own. Steve Bucknell, the seas parted and opened up, and he thought, I'll get myself a nice easy lay-in.
Yeah, I'll accept that version of it. I'm sure a couple of the guys on the team wouldn't be happy.
Leopard struggling to get a shot to go here in the second quarter. There's confirmation of it with another miss. 3 of 15 now. Duck running quickly, had it knocked away, and I think called for the foul as he tried to chase it down. Yes, he was.
I'm sure Duck thought he was hit first. That's why he lost the ball before he fouled.
That's certainly his version of events. The referee walks to the other end. It'll be two free throws as neither side had possession, so therefore the Leopards, as both teams in the penalty, Leopards will shoot two.
I think you also noticed for the first time in the game, Leopards actually have size advantage, except for Martin Henlon. Rico, Michael Martin, their size advantage over the Towers players. So now they don't have the quickness. Maybe Towers are matching them in that level.
Johnson makes the first free throw. There's the two coaches on the sidelines. Bob pacing, Nick, arms folded at the moment. Now Nick has a chance to have a quick word with the official as he jogs past him. Burt into Henlon to Duck. Duck shot is short. Away come the Leopards with Michael Martin looking for some trails and finds Alderson. Alderson for three. Rico Alderson knocks out the three. Little jig to celebrate.
He's very happy with that. I'm going to get my team those shoes because I've never seen Rico hit a three.
Leopards back in front now by a point after Rico Alderson stepped out deep to knock a three down. Bucknell, ooh, just bubbled out. There's a foul in there. Is it on Alderson? Or is it Michael Martin? It's Michael Martin who's been called for it. It's his third, personal foul.
It looks like he stuck his arm in there, but the referee had to be right on the spot to see that one.
Randy Duck gets a breather. Bucknell misses the front end of the free throw. Not like Steve Bucknell that. He's 82% shooter on the season. He's only the third best on his team, but he's the ninth best in the country. Shows what a good set of free throw shooters the Towers have. We are level at 38, just over 2 minutes to go to halftime. It's Rico Orderson backing in on Henry. Nice move from Rico. It's a little bit short, but he might come up with his own board. Good work. Saves it to Kimbra on the far side. Johnson backs out with three, but it rims out, and Johnson and Bucknell collide in the open court. Henry for three, not quite. Henlon going after the board, saves it to Wayne Henry. Oh, a traveling violation called on Wayne Henry as he had a wide open layup. Nick Nurse has a smile on it, but 2 points taken away from the Towers there as Wayne Henry is whistled for a travel going to the basket all on his own.
That was an excellent pass from Martin Henry. I think he just got a little anxious.
Now, I'm always one, if he's making a layup and there's no defense there, I'm not too concerned, but there you go. We're tied at 38. Before the game, we had a chat with Bob Dunwald and asked him what it's like playing the Towers.
You know, we respect them. We respect the talent that they have. You know, guys like Kendrick Warren are above this level of basketball. But we're not in awe of them. We felt that even in the two league games, we had them beat and should have won. And for whatever reason, it went the other way. We felt that in the cup game, funnily enough, that's the game we didn't play as well. We actually felt that we played better conceptually in terms of our offense and better defensively in the other two games. But that was the one that we won. We feel we can compete with them. We feel we can beat them on our night. But overall, in terms of focus, game in and game out, they've gotten us. And that's why they only have one loss, and we're sitting with eight.
That's one thing Bob said at the end, why they only have one loss. Now, a lot of people, myself included, looked at Towers' fixture list and thought, well, they're gonna pick up some losses in the conference just on the basis they're playing so many games this season, and yet they've only lost one. How have they managed to just keep consistently winning through?
I was bolding to Nick, and I think what it is they know the team's in shape. So all he does most of the time is watch films, dissect teams, and shoot. Right, they have the physical energy to do it, just the mental part of the game, that's what he works on, and that's what's getting them over right now. Just mentally stronger than most teams in our league.
Backing in is Orderson, back out to Kimber. Good hands from Wayne Henry. Away comes Burks on the fast break. Burks for the lay-in is blocked. Is that a goaltend? Yes, it is. And I'll tell you why it's a goaltend, because Rico Orderson slapped the backboard, which caused the basket to move, and therefore the ball came off. You're not allowed to hit the stanchion. Here's the steal from Wayne Henry. Now watch this, as he lays it up, Alderson gets the back. Oh, mind you, he might have got the ball first.
I thought he had got ball as well.
I'm not sure on that one now.
I thought he had got ball as well, so I think the follow through is okay if he hit the back.
Yeah, it is, as long as you hit the ball first. Ripped away by Eric Burks, broken up, but Rod Brown will get it back. The three from Kimber won't go, and body's flying. There's a foul called. Rico Orderson is called for it. Yeah, first look, I thought it was a goaltend, but second look, I'm not too sure about it. Here's a look at the foul. Bucknell boxing out Orderson. Little tussle there between the two, and he's called for the foul.
Well, we've seen more contact in the game today than that. But we can't complain, because Ronnie got called for one of those earlier.
Yeah. Rod Brown will sit down. Rashad Johnson will check back in. Check out that. 19 first half points for Rashad Johnson. He's just been lighting it up in the game. He's 7 of 9 inside the arc, only 1 of 4 behind it, but he's shooting the ball well.
Yeah, he's playing unbelievable basketball. He just told me he's feeling tired, though. I think the emotion of this game is getting to him more than anything, because I know he's in shape.
Here he is with the ball in his hands, guarded by Eric Burks. It's lobbed into Alderson. Gets it round to Robinson. Robinson over Henlon, doesn't go. Rebound Martin Henlon. Away comes the Towers with Burks. Burks attacking the basket. Still Eric Burks. And somebody in there got him. If it's Martin, I think that's foul number four on Michael Martin. And Bob Dunnewald throws a water bottle away, you might have just seen. That went, I think Kev might have been able to catch that in the way he was throwing it. But the foul here on Michael Martin, there it is on the arm.
Oh, it's definitely a foul. Michael Martin just has to know where he's at in the game and what time it is. And he's definitely needed for them.
And he goes to the bench with four fouls. We haven't yet reached the halfway point. And you wonder how much more we'll see of Michael Martin. He certainly won't be back now, whether he'll be back in the third quarter or not. But there's Bob with his matching shoes. Burks now perfect from every single distance. 1-1 from behind the arc, 2-2 from the foul line, 6-6 inside. He's got 17 points of his own. Kimber with a tough shot, rims out, rebound Ronnie Baker. Here come the Towers pushing it quick. Still Baker, lobs it back out to Eric Burks. Henry for three, oh, just off the back of the ring. Davis with the rebound. Johnson finds inside Mo Robinson. I think the foul is on Burks from behind rather than Henlon with the block. It is Eric Burks who's called for his first personal foul.
That's a way for Rashad Johnson to get back involved and be aggressively to the hole to create a good opportunity for Maurice.
Here's another look at it, Burks with the block behind. Maurice Robinson off the back of the ring. I think he's questioning whether the Towers might have been into the lane a little early there. Not sure it makes that much difference. And he makes the second and gets himself a breather for the last 14 seconds. Dave Atwell will check in. This is scoring by quarter. You can see the Towers winning this period by 11, having lost the first one by 6. A chance to add to that. Baker for three. Ronnie Baker with a three right at the deck of the second quarter, and the London Towers, who trailed by 11 points here in the second quarter, going to halftime up 8.
In the Towers, 2 championship wins over the Leopards. Kendrick Warren has averaged 26 points. Tonight he has only 7, but his Towers lead the Leopards 47-39.
You prisoners are now the property of the state of Mississippi.
Some friendships last a lifetime.
It's been nothing but pure hell since the moment I ran into you, Ray.
With no parole.
Look at this phone, man. It's filthy.
And no escape.
One of y'all want to hit me down my back?
Eddie Murphy.
How you like that? What you gonna do, Claude?
Martin Lawrence.
You still got that mask? Wanna be my friend now?
No. Looks like we got a couple of live ones.
Life, tonight at 10 on Sky Premier.
The world says, be here, be there, be everywhere. Everywhere. Genie says, be calm. Soon, Genie One will put all your messages, email, voicemail, fax, in one place. The place wherever you happen to be. Genie. Same world, different planet. Trainers. Genie says, no ties. Genie Mobile Internet. Whether you're on Vodafone, One to One, Orange, or BT Cellnet, you're welcome.
And we're at the half of a London derby where the Towers lead the Leopards by 8, 47-39. And the first half, well, full of action. Here the Leopards on a fast break, and Rashad Johnson pulls up. He misses, but Jason Kimbrough says, don't worry. His triple puts the Leopards up 11-10. The Leopards win the tip, and Johnson, watch him. Once he gets the ball, he'll take it strong to the basket. The Leopards took their lead up here by 8. But the Towers decided to come back. Here's a fast break. Watch Warren as he sends 3 Leopards flying. But his team, they still trail 29-23. Randy Duck hits the long one, and the Towers take the lead 35-33. They extend that to a halftime score of 47-39. Towers up, or Leopards up by 11. Towers go up by 8 at half. What happened?
It's just two different basketball games. You look at Leopards in the first quarter, and they were aggressive. They were going all over the place. They were hustling. Towers didn't match it after that decision in the second quarter, and that was the key.
Okay, the change of play. As we look at the match facts, let's see what there jumps out for you, Nigel.
Well, I like Towers' field goal percentage. Now they're up to 52%, and Leopards is down a little.
But you look at the Leopards' field goal percentage, they're number 2 in floor shooting in the country for the season at 51%, 37% in the first half. They have to do a much better job. Look at the rebounds. The Towers lead the country in rebounding. The Leopards are giving them a battle at 21 apiece at the half. Towers average 45 rebounds a game, but it's the turnovers. I think the Leopards have a few less, but the Towers have been able to convert off the Leopards' turnovers, I think, at a better rate.
Yeah.
And you're looking at the leadometer. Here you have up and down for a while, and then once the Towers took the lead, they just continued to build. What would Bob be saying to those guys at halftime?
I think Bob's going to try to tell them to come out the way they came out in the first quarter, to be aggressive, take the ball strong, just be aggressive in the game. Right now, I think they let Towers be more aggressive than them in the second quarter, and that was the key.
You're looking at a guy like Eric Burke, 6-for-6 from the field, 2-for-2 from the free throw line, 1-for-1 from the three-point. Excellent first half. He's finally come out this season.
I think so. I think Burks is feeling comfortable. He's the leading scorer on Wednesday when they played Edinburgh. And I just spoke to him before the game. He just said, just time, just to get in there to feel the team, to get them used to playing with him is what the key for him right now.
Okay, it's taking him a long time to do that. Season's almost over with. So it's been a week for personal and team excellence, as well as record setting. And it's all been detailed in Round the League.
Last Saturday, the London Leopards imposed themselves on a Thames Valley side missing John McCord. They led by double figures at the end of the first quarter and continued to dominate with a strong third quarter, helping them to an 81-63 lead. Despite a late Tigers tear, the Leopards remained in control down the stretch with Rashad Johnson leading all scorers with 36 points in the 109-101 victory. On the same day, the Brighton Bears continued their winning streak with a surprise victory over Sheffield. The Bears took the first quarter by a point, 21-20, and maintained a slender advantage despite effort from Nate Reinking and Terrell Myers. But it was former Shark Wilbur Johnson that led all scorers with 25 points in the 81-75 win. The result overshadowed Peter Scantlebury's achievement of becoming joint highest leading scorer ever in the British League. However, on Sunday, he broke Russ Saunders' record of 8,945 points 3 minutes into the game against the Newcastle Eagles. Scants received a standing ovation from a packed Ponds Forge and was presented with a silver salver to commemorate this massive achievement. The Sharks went on to beat the Eagles 93-88, giving coach Chris Finch his 100th victory as a play caller. London Leopards tactician Bob Donewald has been voted Coach of the Month of February, courtesy of a 5-2 championship record, which included an 18-point victory over the Chester Jets. And Tony Windlass of the Newcastle Eagles was named Player of the Month. The 6-foot-6-inch forward averaged nearly 20 points per game, 6.3 rebounds and 2.8 assists per outing, helping the Eagles campaign for third place in the Northern Conference. On Sunday, the Towers are back in action at Milton Keynes, and the Newcastle Eagles host the Manchester Giants in an important matchup that neither team can afford to lose. Midweek, the North leading teams Sheffield and Chester go head-to-head as the battle continues for top spot, and Birmingham will be looking to strengthen their playoff ambitions when they meet Derby at the Thunderdome. Next week, the MEN Arena hosts the War of the Roses as the Manchester Giants size up to the Sheffield Sharks, and we'll be back live at the Palace as the Towers welcome the Jets at Sky Sports 3 at 5:30 p.m.
Leopards coach Bob Dunningwall might be the coach of the month, but he trails Nick Nurse in career head-to-head battles 10-4. Second half action is next. Towers lead by 8.
With so much new talent, Super League is stronger than ever. The new season continues with two more live games next weekend on Sky Sports. Only the strongest will survive.
The unexpected beauty of the Ford Focus is what lies on the inside. A safety cage that's more rigid than its main competitors. Put your own safety cage in a Ford Focus from £10,460, including a 3-year warranty. Ford demands a closer look.
How much better you feel after a break. Most full and part-time workers are now entitled to 4 weeks paid annual leave. Call for a leaflet.
You are looking sweet.
Where are you going? No, hold on. I ain't finished.
Men.
Oh, my.
I'd love to get my hands on that.
Women. Slip into something sexy. M&M's chocolate. M&M's, the sexiest way to eat chocolate.
From Crystal Palace, it's a London derby, and at the half, the Towers 47, the Leopards 39. Your commentators, Nigel Lloyd and Daniel Routledge.
Thank you very much, Kevin. Yes, the two teams making their way back out here for the second half. And really, it was about the finishes to the two quarters. Leopards finished the first quarter strong, and then Towers finishing the second quarter strong here to open up this 8-point lead.
Yeah, if I'm a coach in this game, I have no idea which team's going to show up, my first quarter team or my second quarter team. Obviously, for Leopards, they want the first quarter team, and Nick wants the second quarter team.
Alderson will jump it up with Kendrick Warren, and Gareth Davis comes down with it. Here's Kimbra lobbed into Mo Robinson. Robinson over Henlon, just about bobbles in for Maurice Robinson.
I think Leopards are going to start inside, start going down low to Mo, make Martin have to play some defense.
Oh, Bucknell bailed Randy Duck out after the collision. He fell over. Oh, great defense from Kimbra. Knocked the ball loose about four times, just couldn't quite come up with it. But he gets the applause from his coach and his fans. He just kept knocking the ball loose before losing it out of bounds.
That's some inspirational defense by Jason Kimbra right there.
Duck lobbed into Henlon. Got to get the shot off. Bucknell to Burks in the corner for three. Off the back of the ring. The first miss of the game for Eric Burks. But he had to get the shot off because time was ticking down. Henlon is fouled by Johnson. Rashad Johnson just reaching in. And a whistle for it.
I know Rashad didn't even want to foul over on that. You could just tell as a player. You just know, oh, I made a mistake.
It's one of them where it's like, what am I doing sticking my hand in there? I'm only ever going to get called.
And it was a good call. He did foul.
Henlon rims out on the first. And gets gets a nice bounce on the second. Towers by 7, a minute into the third quarter. Robinson. Kemba. Kemba, great pass from Kemba. Robinson couldn't finish it off, but Davis gets it back. No reset of the clock. It never hit the ring. They've got to get the shot off. It doesn't matter as Bucknell steals it. And the horn blew because the shot clock had ticked down. But by that stage, the Towers had already come up with the ball. That was a late horn blowing by the table. And
I didn't really see the time on that, but it seemed late. It seemed late to me because they were heading down the court.
The Towers had already come up with it. That was an error, certainly, but they now turn it over as well. They perhaps could have... Alderson shot it short, gets his own, chased his own rebound down. Everybody on the Towers side just stood there, watched Rico chase it down. Look, there, he shot it. Henlon's there, Bucknell's there, Duck's there, and they just watched him rebound.
It just looks like Leopards, they're coming out like they did in the first quarter. They just have full of energy. They're just going after it. They're out hustling Towers right now.
Towers already made their season average 10 turnovers, which Leopards have run back for 14, 8 off 8 the other way. Warren backing in on Gareth Davis, spins on him, fires up under pressure, rebound Randy Duck. Duck sticks it back.
That's a good hustle play by Duck. You don't normally see him down there with the big guys, but he's a very excellent jumper for a guard.
Robinson shot off the back of the ring. Henlon pulls it down. Knocked loose by Alderson behind the back pass. Eventually got to Bucknell from Duck. And Bucknell orchestrating things. Fakes the shot, takes into Henlon. Nice play by Martin Henlon. Oh, it just rimmed out though. Here come the Leopards quickly with Johnson. He's all on his own though, Rashard Johnson. And fires it back out. There's a whistle on the play. Eric Burks is called for the foul. Here's another look.
I don't even think Burks knew he fouled on that play. Everyone looked surprised, but Rob Iverson found something, and we can't argue with him.
Kimber up top.
I'm sure they're going to try to get Rashard involved in this game.
They were trying to run a double screen for him, but Burks was there to prevent it. Now Duck takes over the duties of guarding Johnson. Here's Rico Alderson with the ball. Tough shot from Rico. Don't think it hit the ring. Might have just nicked it. Ball is loose. The shot clock did get reset, so it must have hit the ring. There was a foul on the rebound by Martin Henlon, number one.
That's good hustle by Davis. Young athletic player just kept going after it and finally came to the ball and got something positive for his team.
Looking for his first points of the game here from the foul line. And finding it, trims it back down to 6. Burks behind the back pass to Duck. Warren trying to get it into Henlon, just bounced away from him. Quick outlet to Rico Alderson. Alderson to Kimber. Good block by Button. Alderson tried to put it back. Davis came up with it. Davis' shot doesn't go. Two tips from Alderson. Still they can't get it in. And eventually Eric Burks comes down with it. Leopards really should have got a score somehow there. Knocked away by Maurice Robinson. Towers will keep possession.
Yeah, Leopards were unlucky not to get a score. They had a few attempts at the ball.
Bucknell to inbound to Kendrick Warren. Goes up, went the long way around. Henlon, though, was there to pick the pieces up and stick it back.
If you have to look at Towers' out-of-bounds play, they're scoring on maybe 80 or 90% of the out-of-bounds plays in this series right now. Leopards have really have to do a better job with that.
Johnson, 3 doesn't go. Good rebound, though, from Robinson. Blocked by Kendrick Warren. Here come the Towers with Duck. Duck for 3 off the back of the ring. Doesn't go. Rebound Rico Alderson. Johnson out to Kimbra for three. Jason Kimbra just rims out on him. Davis gives it back to Kimbra, and Kimbra makes the little six-foot floater. There's the offensive rebounding. You can see both teams doing pretty well going after the glass, but the thing that still surprises me is the 17 offensive rebounds that the Leopards have. They're converting it when they get it to it.
Well, the problem is Leopards are getting it. They just need to score. But that's, you wouldn't expect them to get that many rebounds on Towers. The Towers have a big lineup in the game. And Towers is normally bigger than Leopards.
Burks spinning there. 7 of 7 from inside the arc. The only shot he missed was that one where it was rushed at the end of a shot clock that he had to take. 19 points. And he joins Rashad Johnson as the leading scorer in the game. Johnson.
Foul on Kendrick Warren.
Draws the foul from Kendrick Warren, a blocking foul. Number three on Kendrick. Bob Dunnable making wholesale substitutions. Take another look at that foul. Three subs coming in.
I think you have a conscious effort by Rashad Johnson to get involved in the game. He's the team's leading scorer, and he knows he has to start scoring in this half to get them back to the level where they were.
Eric Burks with double his season average. Is that an offensive foul off the ball?
Yes, an elbowing foul by Rashad Johnson. He definitely elbowed Randy Duck. I'm not sure if Duck baited him into it or Duck hit him first, but I know
Here's
Rashad definitely
look.
Elbowed him.
There they are in the post, and you can see.
There it is.
Yeah, there was a little push and shove and an elbow being spotted. Rashad Johnson, number two.
It didn't look that hard, so I don't know. The referee obviously just wants to keep the game going in a positive light.
Lobbed into Randy Duck. He's swarmed on by Leopards players. Loose ball is picked up by Michael Martin. Here's Alexander into the game for the first time. Came in as that trio of subs. His pass is behind Martin, but the Leopards will get it from the side.
That's good hustle by Randy Duck. It looked like he was trying to post Alexander on the other play, down the other end.
Adewale from the elbow doesn't go. Three Towers going after it. Burks comes up with it. Now he hands over to Randy Duck. Bucknell in the corner. Bucknell fires up for three. Steve Bucknell knocks it out. And Towers have opened up a double-figure lead. Kimbra to reply. Not quite. Henlon with the boards. Knocked away by Rico Alderson illegally. Foul number three on Rico Alderson.
You'd have to put that down as a frustration foul on Rico. I think he thought he was fouled when he went to the basket, and then he came back and he inadvertently hit Martin.
Here he is, just knocking him to the ground there.
Either Rico is a lot stronger than we think, or Martin fell. I'm not sure.
Full court defense from Alexander on Duck. Now he turns his attentions to Bucknell and then goes back again. Towers with the biggest lead of the game. Leopards also led by 11 in the second quarter. Bucknell for three again. Yes! Back-to-back threes from Steve Bucknell. And the Towers lead the Leopards by 14.
That was a good shot by Steve Bucknell. That's unselfish basketball by Eric Burks to pass to open Bucknell.
Eight in a row for the London Towers, giving them the biggest lead in the game. Kimbra trying to work against Burks. Shot down to one. They don't see Kimbra gets it off in time, but it rims out. And the Leopards with a 24-second violation. Towers will get the ball back, looking to add to their 14-point advantage.
That was good defense by Towers. Poor offense by Leopards right there. Kimbo didn't recognize, and he ended up taking a shot. I don't think they even got set into any particular offense at that play.
The Leopards shooting in the middle quarters here, absolutely woeful, 18 and 19% after they came out hot. The London Towers have been fairly consistent throughout. Bucknell again for three. Oh! Three threes in a row for Steve Bucknell, and the Towers lead by 17, and that was a deep one.
That was an unbelievable shot by Bucknell. What you say right now is Steve is actually feeling it.
Bucknell, the last nine.
Watch
Towers looking to add. Warren! With the fast break slam dunking out of nowhere. Three threes from Bucknell, a fast break dunk for Warren. The Towers lead it by 19. They've absolutely blistered away.
It's unbelievable basketball by Towers right now.
Steve Bucknell, how about those threes? He did it in the game we had earlier, hit three threes at the end of the game with the game on the line to pull out the win. But that last of the third threes, it was deep. It was tough with a guy in his face, and he still knocked it out.
And if you saw the reaction to Steve after he shot the ball, he's just running on the court side, was looking at the bench. He's feeling it. They got him the ball. He's showing Leopards that they're the team of today.
Here's another look at the last three. Look how deep Bucknell is. Look how far behind the line. Man in his face fires it up. Boom, knocks it out. What a shot by Steve Bucknell. And here's the shooting in the game so far. And you can see Leopards, as we saw in the graphic we had a few moments ago, started the game so well, but their shooting has just bombed out. The Towers are shooting the ball really well. And this is the one that tells you the story of the game. Look at that. Towers shooting above 50 in the middle two quarters. Leopards shooting below 20 in the middle two quarters.
You can't compete with a team like Towers if you shoot that kind of percentage.
And that's confirmed in the points by quarter. Towers 14-point winners in quarter number two. They're up 11 here. Robinson to the fall-away air ball. Rebound, Kendrick Warren. Foul is a blocking foul on Jason Kimbra.
For the first time in this game, it looks like Towers' size is really a factor, because they have Maurice Robinson taking away fadeaway jumpers and they're coming up short. Martin is really making his presence felt right now.
Burks. Kendrick Warren's shot is short. Towers still in the midst of a 13-0 run in this quarter here. Kimber loses the ball out of his hands. Fortunately, it ends up Michael Martin. Alderson gets it back. Shot clock ticking down again on the Leopards. That one doesn't drop either. And the London Towers in no hurry. Randy Duckler says, easy does it. We have a 19-point lead with 12 minutes to go. We've hit the last 13 points. We're looking good. Let's take our time.
This is the European experience right now paying off for Towers. They're just holding the composure and just getting the job done.
Shot clock running out on the Towers. Duck stumbling, got to get the shot off. Warren does in time, and it goes! Count it for Kendrick Warren! With the one on the shot clock falling off balance, he makes it, and the Towers have hit 15 without reply.
Towers, just everything is going with them right now.
And finally, the Leopards get a basket to stop the run. That was Rashard Johnson's first score of the second half after having 19 with a minute to go in the first.
Rashard has to get involved in this game. If not, it's going to go past Leopards.
Henlon backing into the spinning hook. And there's a foul called, 14 yellow, says the referee. Kendrick Warren going after the rebound with the pushing foul, and that is foul number 4 on Kendrick Warren.
I would think besides Kendrick Warren's foul, that's probably the only thing going wrong for Towers today. Everything else just playing good basketball.
There's Kendrick with a little shove in the back. Martin Henlon was going to sit down, but now I think they're going to put Kendrick Warren to the bench.
Looks like Towers
is running. They've gone with both of them on the bench, and they're going all guards.
They're running 6-6 and under squad right now.
Foul called in the post on Wayne Henry, his third personal foul.
This is going to be Towers' time. Leopard's time to make a run. They can pound the glass, because they have the size advantage over all the Towers players. The problem for Leopards, though, is can they deal with Towers' quickness? Who's Maurice Robinson going to guard? If he has to go to Bucknell, who's guarding him, and Bucknell's hitting the threes like that, it's going to be a long night.
Robinson rims out. Yeah, the Towers whilst they are small here, the Leopards, even though they've got a couple of three forwards out there, in fact, they're not actually that much bigger. But we've got here effectively four guards. I mean, Bucknell's big enough to play forward, but shoots like a guard, as we've already seen. Here's Bucknell in the post. Bucknell going strong, blocked by Alderson, gets it back, knocked away by Alderson. Bucknell still going, fires it up, tough shot from Bucknell, and it didn't go.
That was a good play by Leopards. Towers didn't recognize, though. It looked like Maurice Robinson was guarding Eric Burks.
Kimbra, nice. Oh, beautiful pass from Jason Kimbra. Managed to whip it round and finish off get the pass inside. There was a foul there on Steve Bucknell and on Rico Alderson. A double foul has been called. Alderson and Bucknell. It's only number one on Bucknell, but it's number four on Alderson.
I'm not understanding that call, because Rico got fouled on the shot. It must have been something that happened after the play.
Here's another look. The pair of them are inside. That is a foul there on Bucknell. No, I'm not sure on that one either.
The referee must have seen something.
That's a foul trouble. Referee says two shot penalty. They cancel each other out, so it'll be a jump ball. Now they're just going to confirm with the table. I would imagine if it's a jump ball, they could go with any two players rather than the two protagonists of the foul. Bob Dunwell just getting it explained to him. And Rico Alderson will go to the bench, shoved by Gareth Davis. In fact, no, he won't, because it will be the two people involved in the foul. So it will be Rico Alderson who will have to jump.
I'm missing something, because I thought Rico got fouled on as a shooter.
Now they say anybody can go in, which is what I thought it was in the first place.
I thought Rico Alderson got fouled shooting the ball, though.
I did as well, but I don't know. It was a double foul on Bucknell and Alderson. That's what
after,
was whistled.
After Rico's initial foul.
Duck to the basket, throws it out to Henry. Time ticking down. Henry gets it off and short. But the London Towers, thanks to three consecutive three-pointers by Steve Bucknell, have blistered away. They lead the Leopards by 18 at the end of three.
The new Citroën Zara Picasso. Free your mind.
Intelligent Finance is the unique new bank from the Halifax. It could change your life. It is the only bank that connects the money you have with the money you borrow. In any product combination that suits you to make you better off. Intelligent Finance. Call 0845 600 4343 or visit if.com.
Welcome back to Crystal Palace, where the Towers lead the Leopards by 18, and really the shooting stats say it all, 49 against 32.
Yes, I think Towers are just playing unselfish basketball and getting better shots, because Leopards are getting more shot attempts.
And if we have a look at the rebounding, Leopards, part of the reason they get more shot attempts is they're going after the offensive glass really, really well. 17 offensive boards.
That's unbelievable. If you're Bob, you should be winning this game with those kind of stats.
And a look at the leadometer and see how it rises there. Just that massive peak was off the back of those three threes by Bucknell. And we will start the fourth quarter with the Towers leading the Leopards by 18. Now, the Leopards have been in positions like this against the Towers and seen the Towers come back. Can the Leopards do the reverse?
It's a backcourt. They're going
the wrong way.
And that was a backcourt.
They were going the wrong way.
And that
it should
was
have
a
been
backcourt.
A backcourt if they were going
that
the wrong way.
That was a backcourt.
Way.
Jason Kimbrough went backcourt.
He crossed the line. Now the referees are going to have a chance. The two teams forgot which way they were going. Look, he goes across the line, but they're meant to be going the other way. That is a backcourt because he crossed the line.
But the referee didn't call it. That's 2 points. You can't call it back.
Can you believe that both teams thought they were going the other way?
Now, what would have happened if Jason Kimbrough would have shot a three in the other basket? Would we give Towers the score?
I don't know. Now we don't know what it is. Is it a backcourt? It's got to be a backcourt.
What it's got to be, it's got to be 2 points.
Now, Bob is very unhappy. Bob is very unhappy because he thinks you cannot do it. So Bob Dunnewald getting explained to that.
The only problem I see there, right, is the referees blew it, and their calls are blown at times, right? The guy went in and scored. Nothing was called. Why don't we keep playing from there? Why do we have to come back?
Technical foul has been called against Bob Dunnewald. His argument is the thing you're making there is it was never called. Two technicals. Bob Dunnewald has been ejected, and he squares up to the referee before he goes. Kojo Bonso makes sure that he leaves in the right direction. Bob Dunnewald has been ejected from the game, and he will leave.
I'm not siding one way or another, but to be honest, I think you just let it play. You can't come back and take it back.
So it should be 4 shots and possession now for the London Towers, because there were 2 technical fouls on Bob Dunnewald, each resulting 2 in possession. So it'll be 4 shots and possession. And the Leopards fans are still trying to work out what happened to their team right there. The other question is, which end do we take the free throws?
Oh, that's true.
Which way are we going?
The way the game went, you never know. That's just...
Well, it's been absolute mayhem here in the opening 13 seconds. The two teams seem to go the wrong way. The Leopards, by the fact of the teams went the wrong way, were called for a backcourt. Bob Dunnewald, in his extended protest, has been handed 2 technicals, and Steve Bucknell is profiting from the foul line. Steve thought he only got 2, but he got 4 because there were 2 technicals in there. So now there'll be another couple of free throws.
I don't know how Bob could get the tech. Bob was sitting down in the seat where he was supposed to. The referee came all the way over and sat down and talked to him. I think you can just leave Bob alone right there. He's sitting down. He's not pacing up and down. Just leave him alone. Let the teams play. That's unfortunate for Leopards in that situation.
And now it'll be possession for the London Towers, who suddenly lead 71-49. Henry driving to the basket. Oh, he went up high too. Just dunked it over the rim. Wayne Henry
is playing unbelievable today. But that's indicative of the whole Towers team. They're playing just great basketball.
Kimber for 3 off the back of the ring. Rebound and a good outlet from Eric Taylor to Randy Duck. Duck goes for the lay-in. And the London Towers here are cantering away. 75-49 they lead.
And they're still playing tough defense. They've not given it up. They're still playing tough.
Ripped away by Duck. Oh, he just tried to go around the back. Johnson got it back. Kimber with the off the glass stick back, and eventually it's tipped in by Maurice Robinson after the Towers had started the quarter with the first 8 points.
Good hustle by Leopards. I think they're going to still battle all the way through. And I think Bob's teams will play hard even if he's not there. They're that type of team. They compete well.
Duck on his own. Nice move from Randy Duck.
Towers can do no wrong at this particular moment. I don't know how Leopards are going to be able to stop them.
Oh, it came. The pass from Alderson was a little bit too low for Robinson. Came off his kneecap.
Fast break.
Bucknell, all on his own, plants his feet for 3. Oh, didn't quite make it, though. Robinson ended up with it.
It was good to see Steve Bucknell as human after all, because I have to play this team tomorrow.
And it looks at this stage, up 26, as if the London Towers will go to Milton Keynes tomorrow looking to wrap up the Southern Conference title. A win here and a win against Milton Keynes tomorrow would be enough for the London Towers to be crowned champions, although Nigel Lloyd and his team have caused all sorts of problems for the Towers this year, so it'll be a tough game, I fancy, tomorrow for the Towers.
I wouldn't say that. You don't cause a problem if you haven't beaten them. Only time you've caused a problem to a team is when you've got to win.
I don't know.
An 8-second, 10-second call. Oh.
Just got over in time, I think. Bucknell to Henlon, and the foul is called on Michael Martin, and Michael Martin has fouled out of the game.
That's unfortunate for Michael Martin. He's a hard player.
Gareth Davis will check in for him as he goes to the bench. Five boards on the evening. Here's another look at the foul. Just coming from the help side, slapping down. Martin Henlon will go to the line. Henlon makes the first. Going back to your game tomorrow, you took the Towers to overtime, lost on a last second shot, lost by four. I'd say that's giving a team some problems.
Yeah, just a little bit. But we have to finish the game out. Towers is that kind of team, and Bob alluded to that earlier. You have to play him for 40 minutes, and you have to finish the game.
Kimbrough. Robinson through the middle. Knocks it down. London Towers now looking to set a franchise record and a personal record for Nick Nurse of 20 consecutive championship wins. They did win 19 in a row under Kevin Cadle, and Taylor fires up for three. Nurse won 19 in a row in the league last year at Manchester, so they'll set a couple of records if they can just hang on here.
That puts that went to a zone as well.
Oh, Randy Duck wholesale on the head fake from Rashad Johnson commits the foul. There's the Towers fans celebrating early here.
That was a good move by Rashad. He's still trying to compete, way to stay involved in the game. These Leopards players never give up.
Rashad Johnson, he shot way short on that first free throw. Makes the second.
Comes Ronnie Baker's coming with the ball. Towers has even gone smaller than ever. Baker and Taylor on the court.
Yeah, Martin Henlon's wandering about on his own. I don't think the rest of his teammates can see him. He's too tall for them all. They've got a real short team. Got to get the shot off. Henry off the glass. Rebound Gareth Davis. 6 minutes to go. Johnson with the floater doesn't go. Tipped up. Eric Taylor in there, rebound. Lost his footing but still kept going. Here's Randy Duck. Duck, good move from Duck. Just lost his footing but still managed to get the score to go. And Randy Duck seems to have just hurt himself there as he came up on that one. He did lose his footing slightly. The London Towers 81-54 up. There's been a timeout called out by the Leopards. Not sure who's going to take it. Let's go have a listen.
This is a rest timeout, because I haven't actually heard any words being exchanged.
I think Rashad Johnson was the principal talker in there, although, as you say, it was a very quiet timeout. But then you look at the scoreboard, and they well might be they're in a bad position, put it that way.
Yeah, they may just want to. They may have just wanted to rest for a bit and try to make another charge and decide what they're going to do to get something good
Randy
out of this
Randy Duck
game.
Certainly does look hurt. I don't know whether he might have just pulled a muscle there or something, but he certainly lost his footing as he fired up that last shot. And I would have thought with the scoreline as it is, Randy Duck would take no further part in today's game, just as precaution. Johnson, three doesn't go. Rebound, Eric
That's
Burks.
Right. I mean, he doesn't have any big games to play for a while, so he can probably just rest up a bit. I'll talk to Nick about that later on.
Yeah, he doesn't need to play tomorrow, does he?
Oh, no.
Penlin with the turnaround. Rico Orderson will run it back. He'll take his turn at point guard and almost got a good pass through. Henry, not looking, just had his hands in the passing lane and picked it off. Good hands from Johnson to knock it loose. Baker comes up with it.
Right now, both teams aren't playing very good basketball right now. I guess it's because of the score, but Towers aren't even getting what they want.
Baker throws it away.
This is not a good advertisement for basketball right now. Both teams are not playing positive. They need to get a little run together for Leopards to make it interesting.
Towers, 14 turnovers in the game, four higher than their season average. Taylor.
Leopard's still in the zone. Maybe it's the zone that's giving Towers problem right now.
Eric Taylor slices right through it to the lane. Randy Duck has sprained himself. He will not be back. He sprained his leg. He will not be back today. Johnson gets it to Robinson short. Henlon, the only real big man out there, I suppose, gets the rebound.
4-on-3.
Taylor. Good block from Maurice Robinson. Here comes Rico Orderson. Orderson off the glass. Wayne Henry with the ball.
Towers just slowing it down, being a little patient, running a little clock. Hope they're not trying to conserve energy for tomorrow.
You were hoping for quadruple overtime, weren't you?
Yes.
Burks for three, short. Ronnie Baker with an offensive board. That's got to be like his first of his career, probably.
And Martin Henlon sitting on the floor. He's just gotten up.
Henry in the corner with the jumper. 20-footer for Wayne Henry. Kimbra running it back. Slammed in by Gareth Davis.
Good job by Davis.
3 minutes to go. Leopards with only 9 points so far in this quarter, six of them by Maurice Robinson. Johnson has only 3 points in the second half, and he's still his team's leading scorer. Ronnie Baker driving to the basket, count it, four in, he'll go to the line for an and one.
Looks like London Towers can do no wrong. Good, strong, aggressive move by Ronnie. He's still playing.
Mark Spatcher checks into the game for the first time and also coming in for his first taste of the action this year is Clive Lindo, the assistant coach who's suited up since Perry Carter has been out sideline. Don't believe what you read on the back of his shirt. That is Clive Lindo. And he's suited up in seven or eight games but yet to take the call. But he has tonight.
Coaches on the court trying to play. I don't know what this world is coming to.
Ronnie Baker chased down his own rebound, but he needn't have bothered. It bubbled in anyway.
London Towers is now unbelievably small. Now they're 6'5 and under.
Alexander, short. Davis chasing after, tips it back in over Mark Spatcher.
I like the young English guy is really playing. He's still trying to play to end the game. Good job by Davis.
Lindo gets it to Ronnie Baker. Baker driving through, draws the foul. Junior Alexander called for it.
Ronnie Baker staying aggressive.
Baker. Spatcher for three. Oh, off the back of the ring. Rebound, Rashad Johnson. Still Johnson. And he's fouled by Wayne Henry.
I think Leopards have really missed Rashad Johnson in this half of basketball. The first half, he was really aggressive, he was going to it. You got to put some credit to Towers' defense as well, but I think they really missed Rashad in this half of basketball offensively.
3 points in 18 second half minutes for Rashad Johnson. Make that four as he makes the second free throw. Johnson almost coming up with the steal. In fact, did enough to force Mark Spatcher into fouling him as he tried to chase it back.
Leopards still trying to stay aggressive, trying to see if they can get something out of this game to build for the next one.
Alexander attacking the basket is fouled and will go to the line for an and one.
Good strong move by Junior. Got a chance to get up playing time on TV. Way to show something positive.
Alexander at the line for the and one. Misses. Rebound, Ronnie Baker throws it long to Lindo. Lindo couldn't quite keep it in bounds, and the Leopards will get it back.
I mean, Ronnie was trying to get the coach involved in the offense. The coach wasn't ready for it. He didn't want no part of that.
Alderson for three, doesn't go. Rebound with Shaw Johnson, that doesn't drop either. Still the Leopards going after it. And come up with Davis inside. Davis draws another foul from Spatcher. That'll be an ammo. Three fouls in a hurry. On Mark Spatcher.
Good hustle by Dave Atwell. Good hustle by all the Leopards. They have not quit playing this game. Good finish by Davis.
And he converts the three-point play. Oh, Alexander might have got away with a pull there, but Leopards come up with a steal, and Johnson knocks out a three. Tipped out of bounds, and the Towers will get it from the side, and Leopards pressing up court here for the final 65 seconds, not going down without a fight.
Leopards is making a run at this right now, just for some pride, I believe.
They've, I believe, banked the last 11 points, the Leopards here, as they just trimmed the margin of defeat down. Baker did well at first, but then threw it away. The alley-oop to Alderson with the reverse, and even some of the Towers fans were on their feet for that one. That was a great play.
That was an unbelievable play by Rico. Good athleticism, good catch, good finish. Great pass by Junior Alexander as well.
Ronnie Baker will go to the line. It's the Leopards owner, Ed Simons, on the bench. Towers knock spots off the Leopards. Set the sign, somebody knew what was going to happen, obviously. And there is Mr. Simons watching on. His team haven't given up, given them their fair dues here. They got behind, but they've certainly not given up. And I don't think they've given up yet either. They're still fouling to stop the clock. 40 seconds to go.
I think this is what you will say. This is a lack of the head coach isn't there on the bench, because I'm sure Bob would have just let it play right now. But you know, the players, they just want to compete as long as they can, and I think that's what it is. But normally you need a head coach.
Jason Kimbrough there certainly didn't look too pleased. I remember seeing him moments after the Cup semi-final victory that they had, and the thing that he said was at last, because every time he'd played, he'd had a heartbreaking loss to the Towers, and that one there, now you can see how much it means to a man like Jason Kimbrough. Baker to Linda. Linda off the glass, gets his first points of the year. And that's nine of the Towers now on the score sheet. Just Marks Batcher to go. Johnson for three. Baker couldn't quite save it. Leopards will get it back. Lobbed into Alderson. And he's fouled by Clive Lindo as Rico Alderson drives to the basket.
I'm sure Nick Nurse did not tell his assistant coach to foul in a situation like that. I looked at Nick and he did not look happy. And I'm sure when Lindo was sitting on the bench, he would be telling the players, don't foul, let it play. But he's out there now, so players think different than coaches.
Rashad Johnson just going along and slapping fives with everybody on the Towers bench to congratulate them on their imminent victory. Alderson comes up with the steal. Adewell for three in the corner, too long. Rebound, Wayne Henry, they'll throw it long to Lindo, but too long. And Spatcher was wide open on the other side. He was thinking, I could have got my score.
I think Ronnie's trying to make sure the assistant coach is happy.
Davis, the three, doesn't quite go. They've got Lindo will get the last shot, will he? Yes, he will. Fire it up! And an air ball, but it doesn't matter because the London Towers, a blistering spell in the third quarter with three threes from Steve Bucknell, blew open the game. And then a strange start to the fourth quarter where Bob Dunnewald was ejected. The Towers made four free throws. And that was that. The game went beyond the Leopards, but really that spell by Buckner with them three threes was the decisive factor.
I think so. I think Buckner broke the game wide open. He took the game on his shoulder. He was feeling really good, and he decided the outcome of that game.
And Rashad Johnson, Eric Burks, both had great first halves. Didn't do a great deal in the second half, although Burks spent a lot of time on the bench there in that fourth quarter.
I think he put it down to a Towers team. They have more of a team than Leopards did. If Rashad wasn't scoring, Leopards struggled. But when Burks wasn't scoring, Burks stepped up. All the rest of the players that stepped up around him and played excellent basketball.
The London Towers then one game away from the Southern Conference title.
And yes, the Towers are one game away from winning the title. They beat the Leopards 91-75, the previous highest margin in the championship between these two teams. The Towers beat the Leopards previously by 20, but tonight they go away by 16. Down on the floor with Rob, today's MVP with 19 points, 7 rebounds, 4 assists, Eric Burks.
Well, there you go, Eric. I don't know if you heard that. 19 points, 6 rebounds, 4 assists and 2 steals. Not a bad day at the office, and you're the MVP. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you.
What a hell of a game, though, really.
Yeah, it was tough early on because, you know, the Leopards do a lot of running up and down the court. So we're more of a half-court team, so we had to defend not only the transition, but, you know, their up-tempo style. So we adjusted in the second half, and we came out with the victory.
It was a bit difficult start for you guys. You were 11 points down, I think it was 29-18, and then everything just seemed to change.
Yeah, well, early on, we didn't find any rhythm in our offense. Defenses, I think we had a couple of defensive breakdowns on the half-court set, which caused us to get behind early. But as the game wore on, I think we figured out what the Leopards was trying to run. We adjust to it, and we came out victorious today.
Did you get any extra satisfaction out of the fact you've done this against your former team?
Well,
one of your former teams,
well, yes, and you know, because we're just one more game from clinching the Southern Conference, and for me personally, I haven't won a trophy in about 3 years now. So, you know, hopefully we can take care of Milton Keynes tomorrow, and you know, deserve the trophy for the South.
And of course, you've only been averaging about 8 points a game so far this season. You got 19 tonight. You had a big haul in midweek as well. Is this a big change for you?
Well, you know, I'm accustomed to, you know, averaging big numbers during the course of the season. But I'm on a team now where, you know, I got to accept the role that I have, which is, you know, try to be a role player and do my job, particular job, because we have so many scores and, you know, everybody can't share 30 minutes a game. So if I'm out there 30 minutes a game, then I'll produce.
Thanks a lot, Eric. The MVP for 19 points. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And we look at the highlights of the game. The Leopards here win the tip. Johnson gets the ball, shakes, moves, and scores. The Towers take a fast break opportunity. Warren sends three lepers flying and then flushes it. Towers out of bounds. Warren misses the chippy, but Hillen is there for the follow. Towers lead by 8. Buckner then comes up with his third consecutive three off of this hustle play. The Towers led by 16 here. And then London spreads it around. It is the Towers as Clive Lenzo floats one in. 9 out of 10 Towers scored. Final score, 91-75. The thing that impressed me the most about London, when you look at the scope of it, the defensive numbers that they allowed today. Leopards averaging 95 points per game, just getting 75, and most of that was when the bomb squad, as we can call it, came in.
That's true. I mean, I think Nick and them decided that we can't outscore Leopards in a run-and-gun game, so we have to try to stop them defensively, and that's what they did. They stopped them, and then they executed as well.
The guard play of the Towers.
I think it was excellent. I mean, first of all, they have so many guards. They come at you with so many weapons, and they just pass the ball around. They're unselfish. They pass it to open guys, and they give each other an extra step to get a good shot off. They give us just time.
Okay, down on the floor, two guards with Rob.
Thanks a lot, Kev, and here we have Mr. Bucknell, Mr. Duck. First of all, Randy, how's the leg?
I'm all right. Leg came out of me a little bit under the basket down there, but you know, it'll be all right.
It'll be okay for, you got a game tomorrow, and also you've got the big playoff start soon as well.
Yeah, I'm used to it. I get over it quick.
It was a bad start for you guys. I mean, you got behind, and then it all seemed to change, as I was just saying to Eric Burks. Completely changed game.
It's a long game, 40 minutes, you know. We just wanted to match their intensity in the beginning and stay close. And they have a tendency to fade out a little bit after the first, you know, initial blast. So we just stayed close to them, and then we started playing our kind of basketball. And that usually is a successful type of basketball.
And Steve, three huge, and they did you down there, three huge threes in the second quarter. Where do you pick those up from?
Well, it's something that really happened. The guys moved the ball and created good opportunities for me. And, you know, I've been struggling with my shot for the last couple of games, but today I felt like I had to hit some for the team to open up the Leopards defense, and I was able to do that.
Do you feel it was a little bit of a more low-key local derby than it has been in the past between these two teams?
No, I don't think so. Maybe the fact that we've won so many games and we're clear ahead of everybody else, maybe it makes a little bit difference. But we knew it was going to be a very physical game, very emotional game, and a hard game to play in, and I think that we did well tonight.
Andy, just going back to those playoffs against Ventsville you've got coming up, how important do you think it is to try and get the Southern Conference sorted out before you go off to Latvia?
Every game is important that we play. I mean, when we step out on the court, we're trying to win every game. It doesn't matter if it's, you know, school of the blind. You know, we want to win. So Ventsville or Milton Keynes or Sheffield or whoever it is, you know, when we step out on the court, we're going to come at you.
Okay, thanks a lot very much, guys.
Looking at the match facts, I'm sure the thing that's going to jump out of the Leopards shooting 33% in the London Derby, just not good enough.
No, not in a big game this big. You have to get a better percentage, but that's Towers' defense.
Both teams could have did away with their three-point shooting. You have first and second in three-point shooting in the country. Leopards first, Towers second, but neither team was anything to write about.
No, I don't think so. I think what you can say, though, is Steve Buckner's three threes, they did break the game open.
And out of Towers, 18 free throws made. Bucknell made 9. He was 9 of 10 from the free throw line. Offensive rebounds, the Leopards, 25 offensive rebounds. They scored 21 points. The Leopards also off the Towers turnovers. They scored 21 points. You look at those two type of stats, you think you're supposed to win the basketball game.
You do, but then you got to realize offensive rebounds comes from missed shots.
Mm-hmm.
And what happens is the shooting percentage is bad, so of course you're going to get more rebounds. It's just the nature thing.
And Towers, out of those 12 offensive rebounds, they had 20 points. Leadometer just, if you're into skiing, that looks like a nice slope there.
Yeah, that is. Well, it's wintertime, so anyone looking at that would see it. So.
We said the Towers had 9 out of 10 players that stepped on the floor, score for them. Bucknell led the way with 20. Rashad Johnson chipped in with 26 for the Leopards, but it was just the backcourt of Burks, Bucknell, and Randy Duck. They seemed to control the tempo.
Yeah, and I think I was also missing... You're missing Jason Kimbrough from that scoring sheet, and he's a big key for Leopards.
Okay, Baker, Henry, and Taylor join Rob.
How about Ronnie Baker? One heck of a game for you guys. All of you all got a chance to play tonight. Were you expecting that when it came around?
Yeah, first I want to thank God for giving us the opportunity to play this game. And we all got a chance tonight to play the game. I think the team contributed well off the bench.
And yourself, an offensive rebound, did I see that?
Yeah, that must be my first one in my career, I think, so I got to keep up with that. I was pretty impressed with that rebound.
Wayne, you got a chance to get some minutes in as well with some important games coming up.
Yeah, I'm happy to be playing. If I get minutes, I get minutes. If I don't, I still contribute in other ways.
And Eric, you saw your backcourt partner Eric Burks having a heck of a game tonight.
Yeah, he really stepped up for us tonight, and I think he played real well. And the game before, he had a really big game for us, and I think his confidence just carried over, and he played a heck of a game, and I think we really needed him to step up today.
Wayne, getting points is okay for you, but you had a pile of rebounds as well. I think you had 7 rebounds as well. Now, how important is that in terms of getting yourself into some sort of gear for these important games?
Yeah, I need a rebound more. Coach is always on me about that. And today, I guess I was lucky. Something dropped in my hands. I'm happy I got some rebounds, you know. It would be the best for me.
And Ronnie, big game's coming up. More trips for you. Did your wife ever see you these days? Because you're always away with England, with Towers.
Yeah, she gets to see me, I think, enough. I miss when I go away from home, though. But it's all about business when we're on the road. We've got a big game this weekend on the road. This week, sorry. And we're just going to get prepared for that one and hopefully win it. But first, we've got to take care of the game tomorrow against Milton Keynes.
Thanks very much, guys.
Thank you. Yeah, and those group of guys do a lot for the Towers team. But overall, are the Towers just at another level compared to everybody else in the league?
I think so. For the sake of they're playing in Europe. So they're probably end of season because they play so many games. So they're gelling like playoff basketball while we're still trying to catch up because they've played a lot of games, basically, and that's where they are right now.
So where people always talk about where playing so many games is going to make you tired, maybe it doesn't.
No, I think it doesn't. I think it helps with your fitness, and I think it helps with your mental preparation because a lot of teams can't match Towers that way, and that's where they're beating you because they're mentally stronger than you because they've played more games, they've had more wars, and they've been there before, and they've seen most of it.
Martin Henlon, what is his role with the Towers?
He's just probably an MVP to me. You would say Warren, but I think Martin clogs up the middle, does all the dirty work, gets the rebound, excellent passer. He's a good finisher at times, but he just does all the dirty work that it takes to make the team successful. He's an unsung hero.
Okay, Henlon is joined by Warren.
Guys, once again, if I could just have your attention one moment. This has to be easier than you expected, surely.
Well, for the season or for this game?
I'm just thinking for this game, because everybody's been building it up, and yet as it turned out, you got away in the third quarter, and that was pretty much it, wasn't it?
Basically, I think they just ran out of gas. They always come out and play strong, but then, you know, they don't have a bench, so they just ran out of gas.
It all seems to be coming together for you guys as well. This is now 13 wins in a row in all competitions, and it's come at the right time as well.
Yeah, we had a little time to play a little bit more English games, you know, and we started in the jail. But once we got a lot of games under our belt over here, started going from country to country, you know, we come back and play a lot of games here, we can jail more better.
Coming up against Milton Keynes tomorrow, Martin, confident for that one as well?
Oh, everyone's a tough one for us. I mean, it's a battle for me tomorrow. Personally, it's a battle for me. I mean, Jason and Andrew, they're always bringing it to us. And if anything, I would have thought that would be a tougher game for us than this one. You know, there's a lot of emotion in this game. We play so many games, the emotion gets taken out for us. So, you know, it makes it easier for us in this kind of contest. But tomorrow, that's going to be a real war. They're a hungry team. They want second place. We'll have to bring our best game if we want to get 2 points.
Thanks very much, guys, once again.
Cheers.
Thank you. All the best.
You always talk about the players, but where does Nick Nurse fit in this puzzle?
He's found a way to gel a group of great players together, to get them to play unselfish basketball, team basketball, play for each other. And Nick has just brought the chemistry. He's got great players, but it's the chemistry. He's brought the way of gelling them to get them to play for Towers.
Okay, and he joins Rob.
Nick, congratulations, and at long last you get, I think this is your longest winning run as a coach in this country.
Well, that's all right, that's nice. The guys really did a good job. I think, thought we pressed a bit early, you know, not as in a full court press. I just thought our guys were trying to rush things a little bit, but got in a nice little groove there, middle of the second quarter, throughout the third, and did a nice job.
Sorry, Lala. It's been, as a game, it was not the what we expected. I mean, it wasn't the firecracker game we expected. Why was that?
I don't really know. I think, Bob made some comments. Coach Donowall made some comments, earlier in the week about this game was meaningless didn't really mean anything to them because the Towers are going to get first and we're going to get second and we're just waiting to go for the playoffs. So that maybe wound them down a little bit. Our guys, it's important. We want to keep the streak alive. You know, we've talked about winning the league, but we've talked about winning it with a little flair and style. And I think it showed. You know, they were down a little bit and we were maybe a little too tense. But just happy for our guys. They played well when they needed to.
And this team is still surprising you a little bit. I mean, you got an enormous contribution from Eric Burks today, and also you got a huge contribution from him on Wednesday as well.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They are surprising me. I'll tell you what surprises me probably most about them is they're starting to do a lot of things that make teams special. We're starting to guard better. You know, we're not giving up much easy stuff. The guards are rebounding. We're running. Our ball movement's great. Teams throw zones at us. They're in trouble. They're shooting the ball. I mean, doing a lot of things, and like you said, we got a lot of weapons, and it's nice to have Burks go wild. Tomorrow probably Eric Taylor, so it's a nice luxury to have for me.
Nice easy win for you guys, and all the best, especially for the trip to Ventsville.
Thanks a lot, Nick. Okay.
And a big congratulations to Coach Nick Nurse. That's 20 wins in a row in the championship. They haven't lost since early October, but what do you have to do to beat the Towers?
You have to be mentally ready to compete with them 40 minutes a game. You have to just keep the intensity up, hustle, play hard, and just don't limit your mistakes. You're going to make some, but limit them because they don't make as many as you do normally. So you limit your mistakes and just play with intensity and fire and determination.
Tomorrow, you play the Towers in the league. If they beat you, they get a chance to celebrate the championship on your court. Does that motivate your team any more so?
Yes, no one wants anyone celebrating on their court. I mean, I just heard Nick saying Eric Taylor might come out and have a hot game tomorrow, and I'm supposed to be guarding him, so I don't even like that right then. So, no, for the pride of us alone, we don't want anyone celebrating on our court. No disrespect to Towers, but we're coming out to win that game if we can.
Leopards in second place saying a game like this doesn't mean anything, but what it does is it adds a loss to them. Can you guys catch them? Well, I think you're two losses behind them now in the loss column.
We need a lot of things to happen because we're two games behind them, but then also they're 3-0 on us, so they have to head-to-head even if we beat them the next time. So we need help from others, which is what you don't want to have as a coach. You want to be able to do it yourself, but we need some help from others. But anything's possible. You know, anyone can go on a bad streak.
When you look at your team, what is the key to you guys coming in first, I mean, or winning or losing?
If we play unselfish basketball offensively, and if we work our butts off on defense, we're one of the best defensive teams in the league. And when people come in and shoot at they like and just play their kind of basketball, that hurts us. We need to stop them first, and then we have to think about our scoring. But defense is the key for us.
And how are you playing?
I'm not playing like I should, but it's improving as we go, and we're starting to fit together. Just like how Tower said, their guys are getting together. We're starting to find a fit for us, and that's starting to help us feel better about the team. So as up 1 through 9 on our team right now, we're feeling a little more comfortable with each other. We know that everyone's there for Lions.
Okay, hey, best of luck with your team tomorrow and for the rest of the season. It's a big thanks to Nigel for joining us. And next week, it's a must-see cross-conference matchup. We return to the Palace next week as the Towers host Chester. It's a must-win game for the Jets, who are still battling for the top spot in the North.
We ready? Yeah. Let's go take it.
But Robbie Pierce's men will also have the 19-point defeat they suffered to London fresh in their minds. Will the Towers stand tall, or can the Jets score a supersonic victory? Don't miss this massive cross-conference clash next Saturday, 5:30 p.m. on Sky Sports 3. From the team, we thank you for tuning in. Our congratulations today go out to the London side, nicknamed the Towers. We'll see you next time. We'll be right back.
my back. It hurts.
Jets.